Hey everybody, and welcome to the next tutorial. I'm going to call this one 1.5 because I think we're going back to basics a little bit here. A lot of people have been asking me, well, VirtualBox doesn't have sound. How can I run TempleOS with sound? And that's a very easy question with a not so easy answer. You can do a physical install and just get sound that way. But that's tricky, especially if you don't have the right hardware to run it bare metal. What you can do is also you can purchase VMware, which around the time of this video costs anywhere from around $200 to $250, and that will work perfectly. You can make VMs with that, or you can use QEMU, and QEMU is a free and open source hypervisor emulator included with many Linux distributions, and it's also what powers the back end of a lot of proprietary hypervisor applications. And so I'm going to show you today how to install QEMU and get TempleOS running with it, and I'm also going to show you how to get started with Aiwnios. I've never actually heard it said out loud, but Aiwnios, it was made by Nroot. You might remember him from the 5th anniversary video. And what that is kind of like a TempleOS emulator, but it's a compiler. So you can run it in your native Linux or Windows environment and have easy file system management, and you can have sound, and you can play the TempleOS games and code and whatever you want to do with that. So there's a few dependencies for both, and depending on whether or not you want to install Aiwnios, I'm going to show you all the dependencies anyway. So the first main one that we have, boom, okay, here we are. So you can see them all closer now. You can see we're going to update and upgrade the system so that we're running on the latest version and we don't have any issues with our registers or system files or anything like that. And then we're going to install the utils and QEMU system prerequisites. Additionally, we have the GNU compiler collection, or GCC, and the Ninja Build Assembler. The other two things we have here is a low-level pixel manipulation library called pcman, and the C routines library called glib. And with all those dependencies, we'll be able to finally install QEMU, depending on your system. I have for Arch, Debian, Ubuntu, and Fedora systems, there's a different command that you need to run. Lastly, we're going to wget the TempleOS distribution because we'll be ready at this time to make QEMU and set up our virtual machine. And you can see the commands there. I'll throw all these up in the description so that you can see them. You'll see him down below. There, you can see him. Lastly, if you want to stick around toward the end of the video, I'm going to show you how to get Aiwnios running, and it should work on Windows, although I won't be able to demonstrate the Windows capabilities today since I'm on Linux, but I'm going to show you how to build and make Aiwnios. So let's hop into it.
Open up your terminal and type in the first two dependency commands. Update and then upgrade. So update's just going to fetch your packages. Upgrade is going to upgrade them. Here you can see me eating a banana while I wait for all the dependencies to install. It's just a matter of entering your password and fetching the libraries. I'm staring at the banana because it was right next to the fan on the laptop and I am regretting eating it because it's incredibly warm. Here I am attempting to cool the banana down with a fan. Never mind that. If you are not sure what to type in here, I'm putting the dependency commands on the screen so that you can see them very clearly. Again, they're also in the description. Here I'm putting the banana peel on my head and praying so that it will go faster. I'm using my mind abilities, Holy Spirit to a Holy Spirit to make the dependency installs go faster. Once all the dependencies are installed, it's just a matter of running the install for QEMU. With QEMU complete, we can fetch the toss distro from the archive. I've uploaded it so we can do an easy wget here. Otherwise, you could just download it from the church website. This can be quite a long download. With QEMU installed and the ISO for the hypervisor to use, we can tell QEMU to create an image called temple. You can change the 2G to however large you would like the hard drive to be. Then you set the audio drive to the public address. So the public address is just going to be your default audio driver. The next command here is setting the memory as well as the CD-ROM. That's very important that you type the CD-ROM correctly and you set it to at least a minimum of 512 megabytes or else TempleOS cannot run. Make sure to call out the drive file that you specified in the earlier command. Here it's called temple. Then you can just install TempleOS as you would normally. Press yes if you are installing to QEMU. This install could take a little bit longer compared to the one in VirtualBox or VMware, so just be patient. Once it's done, a reboot won't matter. X out by pressing Ctrl-Alt-G and closing out the QEMU tab. You can rerun the command and just remove the CD-ROM because we want to just boot from the hard drive. And there you go, you got sound, everything should be working at this point. It is still pretty tricky for me to pronounce Aiwnios, I think, but yeah, we just want to install the dependency here, the SDL library, and that's the only other one. As long as you've got GCC, head over to the GitHub and get a copy of Aiwnios. You're going to want to extract it to whatever folder you're currently CD'd to in your terminal. You need cmake GCC and libsdl2. So with those dependencies, you should have them all installed except for libsdl. So I'm just installing that. With everything installed, you can cd into your extracted folder, make the build directory, head into the build directory, cmake it, and then run the make command with the j tag. At this point, you can bootstrap the bin file and then just run the bin file. The cool thing about this is it's got incredibly easy file access and file management. So you can just copy, for example, the numbers library straight into Aiwnios and it will run. And you can see it running and you can see after Egypt. And here you can see it running. And here you can see the file. That's basically everything you need to get it running. I'll let the man himself, Nroot, explain further.
So I am Nroot Kanano. I wrote Aiwnios. It's a Holy C compiler and runtime for x86 and ARM.
It's pronounced Aiwnios? How do you say it again?
Aiwnios. The W is actually like an O sound in Greek, eternity in ancient Greek, which I wrote it for ARM, which I think is going to be a feature of computers, so I just called it Aiwnios, so because I don't want TempleOS to die when x86 dies, maybe if it dies. And how it works is when you build it from C, in the makefile list, there's a custom command that it'll compile itself in C, and then once it has the C version of the compiler compiled, it'll compile itself from Holy C, the HGRT2 that bin from Holy C. So that's pretty cool. And how I did it was it looks a lot like TempleOS, and so there's things like labels or like floating point constants, they're in code misks. And what these do is there's things like jump tables, labels, and you make them from the parser. And the parser is generally recursive descent, which means, like, for example, like that all that means is it recursively calls the stuff it wants to have. So like in parse statement, I think it's called, it'll call like the child functions, like it'll recurse into them, like like the if statement will also, like, so it starts from parse statement and then it goes to parse if, and then it will parse more statements. But the only exception to this rule is the expression parser. So how it works is we have the expression, numbers get pushed to the first, and then operators get pushed to the bottom. But if we have an operator that come on the bottom that comes before, like multiplication comes before addition, so the multiplication comes first, or it gets pushed on the stack, and then once we have nothing on the stack, we just push everything to the output, so we get like a stack notation. So that's how the parser works mostly. The cool part of Aiwnios is the fact that the parser is largely the same as TempleOS, because once we compile it from the C side, we compile it from the holy C side. So I made my own RPN class that means reverse Polish notation, and it does that. It's a reverse Polish notation, like operator or number, depending on what's in the union. And there's that. We have our base class at the start. This is B hash class plus zero, because it's like an array, because it's very genius, because Harry made the so it's an array like this, so every time you go up a pointer star, you just add one to the pointer, so it's like an array of classes. Function pointers are also classes. They're technically classes, so I have this dereference type thing here to do it, and this is basically a shunting yard algorithm that I've described. And then at code gen, it just passes it to the C side, which calls our final part, which is x86 backend or ARM backend and the ARM platforms, like the Raspberry Pi, the 64-bit ones at least. So what this does is it uses the stack notation. So I do call toss, I think it was. It uses TempleOS ABI, but I added floating point registers in there. I push the arguments to the stack, and then relocations are basically blank. They're pointers that get filled in. So if you look, what do you call it? There was a relocation somewhere. So relocations will point to a place at the end of the function, and then that place gets filled in with the pointer. So when you import the things in the HCRT to Debian, it'll fill them in for you. It's just fun. And then there's a giant op-pass final, which what do you call it? That's just a giant switch statement, basically. That's basically the internals of it, and of course, you can do cool stuff like, I don't know, play talons. that's basically it for the source of it. So in summary, I start with the parser, which will turn the code into intermediate code, and all that means is the reverse Polish notation that I described. And then that gets sent to the back end. In Holy C, it sends the stuff to the C back end. And then that will output the assembly code. And then that's the stuff that runs.
If someone wants to jump into TempleOS and start maybe modifying the compiler or the parser, what advice maybe would you have for them?
Well, sometimes you just have to write your own code sometimes. And like how I write compilers is I write a compiler and I have it compile itself. So I don't have to understand everything it does, because most of it's Terry's code. Like the Lexer, for example, is basically on a like painted from TempleOS. And so but like you just try reading it, I guess. It helps to know like the theory behind it, like shunting yard and stuff. Just read the source code, and an easy way to do that is to, what do you call it, man, if you have like a function like, what do you call it, clamp i64, you can do Control-Shift-F1, it'll bring you to the source code, so that's a good way to get started.